Hi friends, welcome to Tutor's Funny channel. Today I am going to teach a simple grocery shop inventory management system using Java. Let us show the demo first. This is the demo, right? Now let's calculate the stuff. First I am going to buy sugar only for 500 grams. Select as grams 500. Tea going to buy 2 kilos. Flour going to buy 700 grams and rice by 5 kilos. Right. Now let's click calculate the stuff. Click here, you will be able to calculate here. If it is a 5 kilo rice, this one should be the sugar, this one should be the 1 kilo price. This is the quantity you are buying, 500. So here, this one should be the total of 500 grams. This is a tea, you are buying tea kilos, 2 kilos, this one. Flour, you are buying the 700 grams, this one should be the total, right? So it's a 1 kilo price, 700 grams mean this is the total, right? So all the stuff are calculated and display the total here, right? So let's see how to do this program step by step. Right. Now, here this is the design I have made. So I taught how to make this user interface. So I no need to teach again by again to design this form, right? This is a simple form. This I name it as grocery. Inside the default package, I have designed this form, simple form. This is called as checkboxes. I have taught this tutorial how to do this design this one. I already taught my previous videos. We no need to explain again. So let's see. Let's study the codes, right? So here this one. We have to name it as, right click change it as, I have this all the ticks, CHK1, CHK2, this name it as, this all the name, we have to change the name, CHKN, CHK5, right? Here this one we have to change the name as TXT S quantity, meaning sugar quantity, T quantity, TXT flour quantity, this all the stuff I name it as. This is the grams, this one I have to change it as, this one as TXT sum, is measurement, so SU sugar, this one a measurement, right? This one should be the first two letter T. This one you have to name it as like this T, right? Like this I have to name it as. Okay. Now what I did here is, this one should be the J table. This one should be the bill. You have to change that. Okay. Now let's back to our double click on this OK button. What happened is here I wrote the code. First I have declaring 3, 4 integer variables here. No need the sum. All right. Here sum, right? Sum we need. We declaring 5 variables, double data type should be double, so we have to calculate the price in the decimal point, so that we have to declaring the data type as double. So here this chk1.selected mean, this is the name of the checkbox chk1. If the user select this one, so it is selected, it's called the method is selected, open the bracket and close the bracket. Okay, open the bracket and close the bracket. You can notice that if you click on this one, it's open, it's closing here. Now here, with inside this bracket, we have to create the variable, string variable sugar, right? This is string variable sugar. What is that you are selected here? Checkbox, it is assigned to the variable this, right? Or the measure. Measurement means this one. This one. This check. Right. TXT sum. TXT sum get selected. Dot two string mean this one, this measurement, right? This one, this measurement, right? This is the measurement, right? So here, when you select this one, this is called as combo box. So you have to write get selected item combo. So what is the measurement you have selected here, right? So this is the price I have, the 1 kilo price. You have to put it as this one. Quantity, what's the quantity you have entered here? It is assigned to the variable quantity, right? Now first you have to check if measurement the measure equal kilograms mean. It is calculate the things. It is what is if you are select as kilogram mean 1 kilo. This is a 1 kilo price. What is the price you are? What is the price here? What is the quantity you are entered here? If it is 2, it's kilo calculated by the do this. Calculate and you have to add that into the J table. You have to write the model. You have to create the J table like this. Okay, this we have to. This is J table. Default model J table. You have to write like this. Okay, so you have to easily you have to write like this. J table model, you have to create the J table model object model, you have to get it here. You have to write like this: model row, we have to add the this all the sugar measurement price, all the stuff added into the this 11 columns, right? That's the stuff we have to read. If it is, if you are doing this, if you are not selected as kilogram, if you have to select as gram, calculate the below the stuff, right? I already explained in my previous tutorial how to calculate the grams. Grams mean 1 kilo. 1 kilogram mean 1 kilogram mean 1000 grams. So we have to put the 1000 grams quantity. What is the quantity you entered here? Multiply by price. This is how we have to calculate it. Yeah, display the stuff here. Very simple. We don't need this one. We have to remove it, right? Okay. This is the thing we have to do here, right? You must have to do the stuff, right? We don't need this one. This all the stuff you don't need. Right. Okay. Right. Here, this is the only simple code you have to write. Very simple code. This is a simple code you have to write. Okay. This very simple code you have to write. If you are select as gram, you have to calculate the model. You have to add the model. You have to display the things, right? Very simple code. The same thing you are did here is a, you just copy and paste it here below. This if you again select this second checkbox, not don't put else if. We have to select more than one item, so you have to select as if checkbox 2 selected. We have to do the things. We have only the difference checkbox 2. We have to you have to change the variable MS1. This one should be the this measurement. We have to change the text box name, price, quantity. If the measurement kilogram in, you have calculate this this block of code, kilogram in. If it is a gram in, you have calculate this block of code. We have to do the things so far like this. Okay, we have to do the things like this. You have to write like this. It's easy stuff to calculate and display the total price, right? And finally, you have to display the final total. You have to write the for loop here. Data type double, initial value 0. What are the length of all the data rows you have calculated? Here we have to sum. We have to declare the variable above sum equal double pass in. We have to cast it here int to string. 3 mean 0, 1, 2, 3. J table starting position of 0. 0, 1, 2, 3. Right? That's how it is calculate the values. You must calculate and display the value look like this. Right? With this very simple one. Here, if you have anything to be clear, if you don't understand anything else, you just message me what is the stuff you are not understood so far. It's very simple, right? See, this is a very simple one. Right? The same code here, right? I'll give you the video description. You will be able to download this code, right? It's very simple. I'll be give the code in my video description. You will be able to download and do the stuff, right? Very simple codes. You must try this one. Thank you for watching. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.